Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video discussing what is heat soak, what are some implications, symptoms, causes, and solutions for heat soak. In vague terms, heat soak refers to some part of the engine or the engine as a whole getting too hot, and additionally, its inability to rid itself of excess heat. So really, both parts here are important in defining heat soak. Simply, something getting too hot doesn't necessarily indicate heat soak right off the bat. The second part is really important when it comes to heat soak and that general inability of the engine to rid itself of excess heat. And that's really one of the biggest things when it comes to engines and different systems within the engine heat soaking. Now, there are a lot of different types of heat soak in internal combustion engines. As I mentioned, it may refer to some specific part of the engine or the engine as a whole simply getting too hot and being unable to efficiently rid itself of that excess heat. So a few of the different types. Number one, there's intake air temperatures, and that's really going to be the main focus and main thing that I am discussing throughout this video. And then again, it may refer to specific fluids or systems within the engine or the engine as a whole getting too hot. And that could be anything ranging from the oil to the coolant to the entire cooling system, or again, even the engine as a whole. And then the last common type is the cooling system after the engine is shut down. So once the engine is shut down, the coolant is no longer circulating as the water pump is no longer running. And so that can lead to the engine temporarily heat soaking after the vehicle is shut off. Since there isn't coolant flowing through the engine and cooling things down anymore, that actually allows the engine to begin heating up more after it's turned off. So that's one thing that you'll see a lot when it comes to heat soak. But as enthusiasts, we're more interested in actual intake air temperatures and the implications, causes, and symptoms of that when it comes to performance. So anyway, with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and talk more about heat soak regarding intake air temperatures. Intake air temperature, or IAT heat soak, is incredibly common on turbocharged engines, especially nowadays with so many vehicles coming from the factory with turbochargers and the easy ability to modify them and tune them for additional power and torque. On a lot of modern turbo engines, it's very easy to just throw a tune on there as well as a couple basic bolt-on modifications and nearly double the stock boost, if not even turn up the stock boost more than double, as well as adding 50 to 100 plus horsepower. So what often happens with these turbocharged engines and why intake air temperature heat soak is so prevalent on them is you begin modifying the engine, increasing boost, increasing power, and now you're generating excess heat. Factory intercoolers are often designed with the stock power in mind and not necessarily supporting all of the additional heat and pressures and stresses from increasing boost and power. So that can quickly overwhelm factory intercoolers and ultimately lead to the intake air temperatures rising drastically. Ultimately, what happens when the intake air temperatures heat soak is hot air is naturally thinner and less dense than cooler air. So you'll naturally be losing some horsepower just from the air being hotter in the first place. However, really the biggest thing when it comes to heat soak of the IATs is the fact that the engine is going to start protecting itself due to the fact that hotter air is also more prone to engine knock and detonation. So in an effort to reduce the chance of knock and detonation, the engine's computer, the ECU, DME, or PCM, is going to start to pull ignition timing. It might even take additional measures like pulling some boost and changing some other engine parameters in an effort to protect itself and ensure that the engine is not running into any knock and detonation. So basically that leads to even further loss in power and performance. And on top of that, an overall sluggish feeling for the engine. I'm sure any enthusiasts who have had a turbocharged car, especially with the factory intercooler and started modifying the engine, or even just on a totally stock car, you may have noticed that the first time or two that you do a wide open throttle run or a multi-gear pull, the first time you do that, once the engine reaches operating temperature, everything feels great. It feels powerful. Nothing feels off or sluggish. However, after you do a couple pulls or a couple multi-gear pulls, all of a sudden you hit the throttle and it feels like you're losing a ton of horsepower and the engine just feels sluggish. And then you can't get back to that same point. Even after driving around gradually and letting the engine cool back down a little bit, it just doesn't feel as powerful and alive as it did before. That intercooler and the air intake temperatures are already so hot and everything's already heat soaked. And so again, one of the big things with heat soak is just that inability to rid itself of excess heat. So basically the intercooler core, the intercooler, all the metal on the intercooler just gets too hot to the point that it can no longer efficiently cool the charge air. And so that's really heat soak at play there. Now, I mostly talked about turbocharged engines here. Of course, this can happen on naturally aspirated or supercharged engines as well. It's just mostly common on turbo engines because of the nature of turbochargers actually running off the exhaust gases. Of course, the turbos themselves get incredibly hot, which means that the air is heated as it's compressed. And so that means that the air can get incredibly hot. And that's what ultimately overheats and heat soaks the intercooler. So that's why it is most common on turbocharged cars. Regardless of what kind of heat soak you run into, it is important to address with the necessary upgrades and changes to the engine and vehicle as necessary, because heat soak does have a lot of different implications, anywhere from losing horsepower, losing performance, the vehicle just feeling sluggish, especially when you talk about intake air temperatures heat soaking. But going further than that, other things heat soaking, like the cooling system, engine coolant, engine oil, that can all have negative effects on reliability and longevity. Of course, overheating can lead to issues like the head gasket failing and cracking. Hotter oil temperatures can result in reduced lubrication throughout the engine. And various systems can really just have a lot of different implications on long-term reliability, longevity of the engine. And then again, also in the shorter term, you might notice some performance implications with things like power loss and just sluggish and poor performance overall. Now, fortunately, the solution is generally pretty simple. It often boils down to just upgrading your intercooler. A lot of cars use an air-to-air front mount intercooler, so just upgrading to a larger intercooler with a bigger volume and a more efficient core can often help bring those air intake temperatures back in check and really mitigate any of the IAT heat soak that you're experiencing. So pretty simple upgrade if you're running into that on a turbocharged engine. It just comes down to a bigger, more efficient intercooler that can appropriately handle the boost and the power that you are running on the engine. Speaking of intercoolers, that leads me into one final topic to hopefully help clear up heat soak and provide a little bit more information and detail as to specifically what heat soak is. So when it comes to intercoolers, air-to-air intercoolers are the most common. They're often mounted on the front of the vehicle and known as a front mount intercooler or FMIC. However, one thing that's becoming a lot more popular nowadays is an air-to-water intercooler. And so unlike an air-to-air intercooler, which as the name suggests, an air-to-air intercooler relies on air to actually cool the charge air, an air-to-water intercooler is almost like a separate cooling system. It relies on a water and coolant mixture to actually cool the charge air. Ultimately, these air-to-water intercoolers are becoming a lot more popular on factory turbocharged and forced induction cars nowadays. An air-to-water intercooler is less prone to heat soaking because a water and coolant mixture has a much greater heat carrying capacity than air does, and so that can help prevent heat soak. However, a lot of race cars actually still utilize traditional air-to-air intercoolers. Part of the reason for that is heat soak. So again, even though water and coolant mixture will have a greater heat carrying capacity, once the water actually begins heat soaking, it's going to be much harder to cool that back down. Simple to think about: if you live somewhere near a lake, if you get one warm day in the middle of winter, that doesn't mean that the lake is suddenly warm and you can go jump in and go for a swim. It's obviously going to stay cold for an extended period. It takes quite a bit of sunshine and consecutively warmer days to actually heat up the water again. Or likewise, in the middle of summer, if you have one cold day or a quick cold front run through, the lake isn't going to be suddenly freezing cold. So that water is going to take a lot longer to heat up or cool down compared to air. That's why a lot of race teams still opt for air-to-air front mount intercoolers, because even if they do experience heat soak, it's a lot easier for the intercooler to begin ridding itself of that excess heat, because again, air just cools down and heats up a lot faster than water does. Hopefully that provides a little more insight as to what is heat soak, since it isn't just always about something getting too hot or overheating. It also boils down to how quickly that component or that system can actually rid itself of the excess heat and get back to a standard range for operating temperatures. That wraps up our video on heat soak for intake air temperatures. In summary, heat soak is a much broader term that can refer to a lot of different things. Again, it could just refer to different fluids or different systems, like the cooling system overheating and not being able to rid themselves of excess heat, or the engine as a whole in cases where things can really get out of control when it comes to heat soak. Once one system starts getting too hot, that can lead to other parts of the engine getting too hot and also experiencing heat soak. So it can be a vicious cycle where one part of the engine heat soaking actually causes multiple systems and multiple parts of the engine to also experience heat soak. joke. Anyway, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, guys.